Savage, Rob Cross. Das Duell der 2 gegen die 3 der Welt. Auch er hat schon 2 Major-Turniere gewinnen können, den World Grand Prix 2017 und im vergangenen Jahr die Players' Championship Finals. In diesem Jahr kam sein erster Erfolg auf der European Tour hinzu. Aus Nordirland, Super Chin, Daryl Gurney!
Touching warm, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
Der Bühne. Kennt ihr von vielen, vielen Fernsehübertragungen. Herzlich willkommen, George Noble.
Well, the opening couple of games here on the final day of the European Darts Match Play have been absolute crackers, featuring world champions and national number ones, and it continues in a similar because we've got 2 of the top 3 ranked players in the world. The world number 2 and English number 1, Rob Cross. The world number 3 and Northern Irish number 1, Daryl Gurney. A world champion in Rob Cross. A 2-time major champion in Super Chin. And it is a repeat of their epic World Match Play semi-final. In fact, this is the 9th time these two have crossed swords this year. They have been running into each other in the back end of tournaments week after week after week in 2019. And by and large, Rob Cross has got the better of it. I think... And he's discussing with George Noble, is it a loose floorboard or something? Or is the hockey perhaps a little bit loose? I'm not quite sure. Can't figure it out. Daryl Gurney doesn't seem to have any issues with it.
I was trying to figure out whether he was having a look at his front leg because his trousers are actually overhanging the hockey.
Well, I mean, that's all right, isn't it?
I think that's fine.
I mean, if he walked on there with like some big flared loons and they were like... a good foot over the hockey. I mean, as long as his foot isn't there, he's all right.
I think that's the case.
Oh, George Noble seems happy enough with it.
To throw first. Game on.
He's been called a few times over the last 3 weeks, George Noble. He's been utilising his knowledge, experience and skills. He's been tested with photographers and unruly fans. And behaviour of players.
He doesn't stand for any nonsense, George Noble. Whether on stage or off it.
100.
I think it's fair to say, Dan, you're absolutely right at the start of this match. A couple of blockbuster games to start this afternoon. 6 consecutive major champions to start the Sunday. Doesn't get much better than that.
Yeah. And then we've got guys who are quite regulars in European Tour finals in Dave Chisnell and Ricky Evans. Dave Chisnell, a 2-time finalist in this particular event. Ricky Evans, a 2-time Euro Tour finalist in the last year.
100.
Every single one of the seeded players coming through in this half of the draw, and it throws up some big name clashes. big name clashes in the other half as well. It is a tantalising lineup, and the players are delivering so far here in Mannheim. You're expecting these two to deliver. Daryl Gurney has won his first European Tour title this year. He beat Rob Cross along the way. That was at the German Darts Championship. However, it's one of only two wins he's had this year against Voltage. The other one was in Melbourne on the World Series. Cross has won their six other contests, including that heartbreaking one for Gurney at the World Match Play. Cross going on to lift the title. 167. Nobody ever takes a 167, do they? They don't even get close to doing it. That's Gaby Lewis. Oh, hello.
Same result.
Cross.
Where will he go for this 111? 19s. Double 16. Very good indeed. Sharp as you like.
And
Voltage yesterday against Marvin Vader, the first four legs, he was just a mess.
Yeah.
But then he realised he didn't really have to play that well, and he just got over the line.
Yeah, we saw it a number of times in the Premier League where he'd go on these runs of legs, four, five, six legs even, where he's pinning the double first dart. Whether he'd left himself on a double with three darts in his hand, or it was the end of a combination like that. And he just seems to get in this groove. And if there's a chance, it goes. And it keeps on happening. And he can take games away from you. Did it to Daryl Gurney in the Premier League. Did it to pretty much everybody apart from Michael van Gerwen in the Premier League this year. But Gurney, of course, made the playoffs as well at the O2. And he wasn't that far from toppling MVG. This could have been the Premier League final.
How much do you think Rob Cross is craving Premier League title now, because he knocked off the Worlds first, now he's knocked off the Match Play, wants to be a Triple Crown guy, and Premier League is next, and he really wants to win a game at the Grand Prix.
Yes, right. Probably help if he wasn't drawn against Steve Beaton.
Well, we know it's going to happen again.
Yeah, quite possibly.
It'll just happen.
And the thing is, because, yes, he's a big scorer, Rob Cross, he can do everything, but his doubling is one of the best doublers in the game, particularly on double 18. You would think that the Grand Prix lends itself to his 99. Game. I mean, Daryl Gurney himself, you know, has won the World Grand Prix. Double 16, big favourite of his. But he's also a very good pressure finisher. He's finishing against Peter the World Match Play in the quarterfinals is some of the best I've ever seen.
93.
But it managed to help him to the Grand Prix title. Rob Cross, if he can get past the first round, might be able to do it. Oh, well, he stayed there and he found the treble 20, leaves double 10, and he pins it. One apiece.
Daryl Gurney is one of those players who has that rare ability to just tell a dart to get out the way. That's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, just ghosts it through, doesn't he?
Yeah, these guys, for me, are probably two of the top four doublers in the world. I mean, Rob Cross, during the Premier League, he was top. Somewhere around about the 45-47% mark, and try doing that at home.
95.
Hit 47 doubles out of 100.
Yeah, that's 47% over 4 months. I mean, that is spectacular.
Under that kind of pressure.
Yeah, absolutely.
137.
It's probably been the biggest improvement in the Gurney game in the last 3 years, and it just goes to show how much of an improvement it has been, because the Grand Prix for me is
16.
One of the hardest tournaments in the world to win, because we don't play enough double start darts.
Yeah, different rhythm to the game, isn't it? You know, you're getting, there's always pressure every visit you step up, but it's a different kind of pressure when you've got to get off.
79.
And all of a sudden you can find, well, I've given up the throw, or I'm 200 points behind here, and the pressure is mounting before you even get to that crucial stage at the end of the leg about whether you can win the leg.
Yeah, there's more swings in leg play. We're talking straight start about he's got the throw now. Well, if we talked about that with double start, we'd be talking about it pretty much every minute.
57.
Yeah, well, quite possibly. I would imagine. I mean, did you find it? What was your best run at the World Grand Prix?
Quarterfinals, and should have been the semis. I missed one dart to beat Wes Newton. Wes Newton again.
Wes Newton.
119.
Yeah, I would have played.
Robbie McCoy, 129.
Michael van Gerwen in the semi-finals, and he went on to win the title.
Hang about. Rob Cross loves the double 18. And pins it twice. That is spectacular stuff from Voltage.
Game on.
When we say players don't leave Ratajski on 32, well, don't leave Rob Cross on the opportunity of hitting double 18 once or twice.
98.
Three legs, all three, ton plus checkouts. And you're right, of course, Rob Cross, the 18 segment in general is where he does a lot of his best work. But if he's hitting it at the start of a game, whether it be the double or the treble, then look out, because he might be about to do something massive. And Cross, sometimes you'll see him, particularly at the start of matches, he'll be going for treble 18 and he pulls it a lot into the fours. And he gradually works his way in there. But once he starts hitting, he just keeps on battering.
Yeah, the 18 segment for Rob just seems to fit his eye. You see certain golfers who like holes that dogleg from left to right because they hit that sort of shape.
But
with darts, sometimes a certain segment just sits at a good height. And for Rob, it's the treble 18, it's the double 18. It just seems to fit.
80.
When he brings that dart down his dominant eye, which is his right eye, he's just deadly in the northeast corner.
Well, he's earned himself an advantage and helped out by that bounce out for Darryl Gurney. Leaves himself the 146. Gurney looks good. Looks very good.
140.
Tell you what, an extra 60 points or 40 points here or there could have been the difference.
Yeah, I agree. This time Rob looking at 619 to leave 32.
93.
Yet again, pokes the eye at that 54. Oh, central. Looking for double 11. Oh, that's amazing from Gurney. That's how you come back from a fall out of the board. He'd much rather have been on 64. But boy, is that a classy shot.
Very classy, and you can see that release of frustration from Darryl Gurney, because that's all about the bounce out. He felt he'd been wronged there, and then he's managed to put it right. And it is four legs won, four ton plus checkouts. Not a single leg have we seen above 15 darts. In fact, they've all been exactly 15 darts.
I understand. I've been surveying the Gurney game for about last month. I haven't seen him this sharp. And yes, he's played better in his career. But right now, he looks pinpoint to me mentally. He looks rested and focused and practiced. For me, he looks ready to defend that 100,000 points at the end of the month or the beginning of the next.
Yeah, he does look sharp. And he said after he won his John Henderson, it was a good contest, he was pushed. He did say, I felt I probably should have won one of those titles down in Australia and New Zealand. I thought I was playing well enough to do it.
Well, Darryl, if you're going to win a title, make it a ranked one.
Yeah.
That'll get you in more World Series events. And there's that flamboyant, jumpy, jerky dart that he throws sometimes.
It's always it's the first two in the treble 20, and he'll give it. He'll walk and he'll jump and he'll try and just force it in for the maximum. I know he's one of the biggest maximums in the world. Can't really fault him.
86.
Should stay there. He's gambled on the 60 for double. Four, and he's hoping that Cross doesn't get 619s for bull here.
Bull's move in a game with four ton plus checkouts out of four legs. Treble 18 he'll start with, but he doesn't quite pin it. And the gambit has paid off. This is the first leg where Rob Cross has thrown 15 darts and hasn't managed to win the leg.
For the lead. Gurney takes the lead. Saw a glimpse in the audience there of Team Cross. John Archer, manager of Rob.
Game on.
Right-hand man of John Archer, Jim Walker. The legend that is Jim Walker.
The Phoenix.
Boy, that first dart's been good today from Gurney.
100.
What an afternoon of darts this is turning out to be. Mensur Suljovic really testing Michael van Gerwen, but going down 6-4 in a repeat of last week's final. Adrian Lewis missing 167 on 83. The ball to win in the last leg decider against Christoph Ratajski, who maintains his perfect record against the two-time world champion. And now, these two, in their ninth meeting of the year, serving 100. Up some proper high-quality stuff. Something you would expect from the world numbers 2 and 3.
We've had, over the course of the last 20, 30 years, some definitive rivalries within the game. We've had Eric versus John Law. We've had Manley and Taylor. And, well, everybody's had a rivalry with Taylor at some point. MVG versus Taylor was a proper
100.
One. Could we be looking at one here? They've been going at each other all season long. And we may well see them in more important games in the future. That 60. Could be the start of the big rivalry, that semi-final at Blackpool.
Well, there you go. There's a Super Chin shirt in the crowd. And look, he may not be. It's mad, really. Dal Gurney may not be the most heralded player. He may not get the respect he deserves. He's a world number 3 and a 2-time major champion.
He gets respect from me. I think he's an awesome player.
Absolutely.
The one thing he's done that's the most impressive for me, aside from improving his doubles, is cultivating a way of playing on stage that makes him so deadly.
Does he stay there? He does. Leaves double 11. Oh my, it's nearly another ton plus checkout from Super Chip.
Boy, that was close.
If this treble 17 goes first dart, Rob Cross takes this leg. There's no doubt. It's double 18. The finishing here, he's not missed a dart at doubles yet. This goes. I was lying to you. I lied.
I thought you were paraphrasing a Jimmy Neal song there. 11. Ain't no doubt it's plain to see.
He's lying.
A double like you is no good for me.
It's double 4 good for Gurney. No, it's three. Not. Cross starts to miss. Gurney joins in. Not a fun game to be playing, that game. Slap bang in the middle of the one. Good enough in the double four as Cross breaks back immediately.
Really interesting exchange there. Not only does Rob Cross steal that leg, tries to a bit of eye contact with Darrell, and he's having none of it. His eyes were firmly on the carpet.
140.
I'm a big, big fan when players try to make eye contact, but I'm an even bigger fan of the guys who don't make eye contact.
Well, look, we were talking about it off air, weren't we, when you were talking about Phil Taylor and you took him on, where was it, the UK Open?
UK Open 2011.
And you went up there purposefully, I'm not going to engage him, I'm not going to look at him, I'm not going to talk to him, I'm not going to play his game, I'm not going to let him feel comfortable.
Yeah, Phil used to be one of those guys who would try and bring you into his world. And if you stayed in your own bubble and stayed on his exterior,
140.
You couldn't really beat him at his own game, but you were just playing your own game. And for me, the key to playing Phil was not making eye contact. If you made eye contact at all, he had you.
64.
Wow. There are plenty of ways of winning the game of darts and getting your opponent to lose a bit of focus. You can see various ways to do it. Gavin Price's big aggressive thing to knock you out of your stride, out of your bubble, as you call it. Even just have a little friendly chat and a joke. You see AD Lewis do it a lot. Tops for Rob Cross.
97.
But it's still an authoritative leg here from Voltage, and he's going to come back with more opportunities to go back into the lead. Gurney got himself in front, but he could not consolidate that break of throat.
60.
And he's chasing.
Probably required 20.
Does understand the complexity of best of 11, Gurney. And he'll understand that, yes, he's 4-3 down now, but that was on throw. He's going to have to rebound pretty quickly and use that mental strength that he has, because that leg, he seemed a little rattled by the missed doubles from the previous leg. But a 96 average from Gurney right now, and an elevated cross average, which has climbed over the last three legs, up towards that 99 mark. This is what we expect from these two players here. This quality stuff, and it's tight.
Yeah, and this is certainly what you expect from Rob Cross, because this 99-100 average is what he's done all year in every single tournament. That's more like it. That was a very calm one from Gurney, wasn't it? There was no movement there.
Relaxed and easy. Every dart has everything behind it with Cross, but the thing about Gurney sometimes, he throws with such fluency is probably the right word. And he's statuesque as well. Just makes it look simple.
92.
Great finishes.
And he can just say, Gurney, he had that big sort of roar earlier on when he was frustrated at a bounce out, still managed to win the leg. Now, he's gone into sort of Gurney sulk mode, where the shoulders slump and he's not reacting. But all he's doing is trying to keep calm. He knows he's got a very big task on his hand to turn this game around. And his best chance is if he just keeps calm, doesn't engage with anything. Just focuses dart by dart. And he can play some incredible stuff like that, even though it looks like he's kind of disengaged from the match. But Rob Cross might be about to do something very special. Oh, my word.
97.
Now
we require 124.
This looks familiar. Oh, slip into the treble five, and now he can't go out. And Cross has options, single 20 59. Or single 16. Don't envisage him ever going for 12. He's going for the 20. Double 16. To get a two-leg gap. Take advantage of that slip on the last dart of Gurney.
Laughs it off. But that opens the door for Darryl Gurney. Tops.
Oh, excellent 25 in tops. Gurney. And a calm celebration, a little flick of the eyebrows. Just had a great idea for a t-shirt for Super Chin. Keep calm and walk on.
Well, that is kind of... I mean, look, I like seeing Darryl Gurney fired up. I think it's entertaining. But he does have the, he does have this mode he goes into quite a lot. Because he says if he, if his adrenaline gets going, he loses 100. Control of his darts. His darts go haywire. They go all over the place. He needs to keep calm. That's why a lot of the time he doesn't celebrate. Now, we have seen sometimes he's able to do both. Keep control of his darts and still have a bit of fire and passion. I think Rob Cross is actually much better when he gets really fired up.
I completely agree with that.
100.
Remember that finish he took out against Van Gerwen early in their semi-final at the Worlds, and he started giving it big, and I thought, who is this monster?
Yeah, those big combination checkouts were very much a signature in his first year in PDC darts. Nowadays, I mean, I don't... Double 18, but he just does everything well. Now Gurney's become one of those players, he does everything well.
100.
Don't see a particular weakness in the game of either of these two. That's why they're ranked number 2 and 3 in the world. That's why they've both got two major titles to their name. And I expect them to add to that.
77.
Oh, the old insurance policy there from Rob Cross. Doesn't leave him an ideal number. And if Darryl can get himself in the 60 here, 60. He cannot. Still advantage Cross. 31.
Won't be using the treble 17 here. Tries not to use the treble 17 segment, Rob Cross. Does all his work on 20s, 19s and 18s. They're the ones he practices on. He says, if you see me going to the 17, something's gone wrong. 41.
Possible. Only just over the top of the 57.
94.
You can't envisage a scenario where Rob Cross doesn't hit this 32. Oh,
I thought that earlier.
He's on the ninth leg, Rob Cross.
But Lightning does not strike twice, and the Super Chin fan, worrying times.
Is that the invitation that Rob Cross desired? Winner of this one will play Dave Chisnell or Ricky Evans, who Daryl Gurney beat in his European Tour victory earlier this season, where he was getting some sort of mild kick in the head when he beat Ricky Evans. Not literally. They don't do that to each other in darts. Well, not anymore. That's a some form of kick in the head.
Right, are we going to see another game go to last leg decider?
54.
That visit makes it much more likely. Gurney did beat Cross at the German Darts Championship. He did beat him in Melbourne, but he lost in 72. Brisbane, in Blackpool, at the German Darts Grand Prix, twice in the Premier League, all this year. Only playing each other in big stage matches all over the world for hangabout. Gets him back in the leg, that one.
They're very evenly matched. We want to see an 11th leg. Looking more likely now. Options. 16s maybe. Or
140.
Well, thought about it. He's only got the two maximums, Daryl Gurney, and 10 legs of darts, but he's had a fair few 140s.
He's looking at the two treble 20s there as if to say, you know, he's looking at a menu and he doesn't know what to order.
78.
What am I going to have?
How are you
BLT?
52.
Meatball sandwich? Nah. I'll have this leg though. He needs the same double that Cross got in the last leg.
36.
And he's invited Cross in to one of Dart players' favourite big checkouts.
He's taken out two ton plus checkouts in this match, 111 and 129. 129's trickier than this one. Although it's just got a little bit trickier. Superbly done. Bullseye for the match. And a spot in the quarterfinals.
105.
Relief for the
Daryl
Super Chin fan.
16.
This has got to go. That bullseye has been very important this afternoon already. It has denied Adrian Lewis a match.
Wrong side of it. And relief turns to 25. Anguish. For the Super Chin supporters, because Rob Cross steps up and gets two more match darts. The stop, the wipe of the hand, the pause, the staring down of the double, and the pinning of it bang in the centre. And Rob Cross beats Daryl Gurney for the seventh time this year. Another cracking contest between these two, with big finishes left, right and centre. But just a few too many misses from Super Chin costs him a spot in the final session of action. And Rob Cross, a man who made the final of the European Tour event here in Mannheim 2 years ago, is on course to equal that feat. And who knows, maybe surpass it to get his first Euro Tour title. Cross faces either Chizzy or Rapid Ricky. Those two takes the stage in a moment.
Applause for Daryl Gurney. Rob, congratulations. A close one, huh? Actually, I thought the eighth leg was actually important. There was the chance for you to get up 5-3, and then he got it. He got the 4-4, and it was real close at the end.
Yeah, definitely. The game just didn't go to plan. Daryl never fired, I never fired, and a couple of good checkouts earlier on probably would have settled him a little bit earlier, and if he would have won one of them legs, you would have watched a real Daryl Gurney turn up. But no, I'm glad to be through. Obviously got to improve for tonight, and which I think I will. I just got to relax a little bit more.
What is the most difficult part of such a Sunday, playing four matches if everything is running well?
Well, obviously everything for me, because I never won on that.
But you reached a couple of finals, yeah?
Yeah, obviously I enjoy them. I think the gap at the end is what kills me. I get like 10 minutes or 15 minutes to prep. Sometimes, yeah, you want a little bit longer. But it is what it is, and you have to enjoy it and just sort of come out and sort of vote for the best in that game especially. But I'm still glad to be in the tournament, and hopefully I'll wake up later.
Good to see you later again. Thank you very much. Rob Cross!